guys, I have your notes here for section 7-1, days 2 and, no, days 1 and 2, section 7-1, days 1 and 2. And for this particular section, it's less about procedure, like you've been doing with all your integration techniques, and it's more about understanding. So, I really need your brains on this, during this video and during this homework, okay? It's not just do this, do this, do this, do this, and you'll get an answer. I want you to understand differential equations. So, sorry, blanked for a minute. Differential equation is how you can recognize a differential equation is it's going to be a derivative. It's going to be a derivative of something. But in your derivative, you're going to see the original function. And a differential equation is largely the result of when someone did implicit differentiation to find a derivative. That's what results often in a differential equation. So if we go back to way back to section 4.2, when I showed you how to do implicit differentiation, this is where no longer is your equation set up as y equals, and you just write y prime equals. Your y is like buried inside your equation, and you can't get it out. You can't solve for y. So you just have to start on the left side and just start plowing through and doing derivatives. But remember, as you start plowing through and doing derivatives, if you could have solved for y would represent some messy function. X is your variable. So when you do a derivative on a term that has an x on it, that's going to be an easy derivative. When you do a derivative on a term that has a y in it, you're going to have to remember, oh yeah, y is messy. I need to multiply by the derivative, do chain rule. So I got the derivative of 2y is just 2, and then chain rule it. The derivative here is power rule it, and then chain rule it. And then this derivative is easy. And then I kind of did several things in one step here. I factored out dy dx. I divided by the quantity 2 plus 6y, and I knocked everything down by a factor of 2. So here's the thing that I want to show you. Check out this derivative. It says, this is the derivative of the function y in terms of x. X is your variable, but you don't see an x over here. All you see is a y. What is y? Y is the messy function that we didn't know what it was originally. This represents the original function. So since my derivative has a y in it, this is commonly known as a differential equation. Alrighty, now, suppose you have a function, it's just a polynomial, in this case with some type of constant out in front of it. I would call this an unknown function because of C. So the specific function is unknown because of C. C could be anything. So C could be 1, C could be 2, C could be a negative, whatever. And because there are so many possibilities for C, it doesn't matter what C is, this is still a quadratic. The graph is still a polynomial. So no matter what C is, we have all these possibilities for what this function could be.
no matter what C is, each individual function still is, they're all similar to each other, okay? So when I have a function that has a C in it, I have unlimited possibilities of what C is. This is often called a family of functions. Kind of weird. But when you have a function that has an unknown constant in it, a constant could be anything, when you look at all of the possibilities of all of the functions that could be made depending on what C is, that's called a family of functions. Now, suppose I have y prime is equal to 2y over x. Do you know what this is called? I hope you were paying attention a few minutes ago. Because it's a derivative that contains the original, this is called a differential equation. Now, here's what I'm thinking. Kind of some vocabulary here, ready? I think that this function is a solution to this differential equation. I think this function is a solution to this differential equation. And I'm gonna like prove it. So I think that if I did an antiderivative on this, I would get this. Or if I did a derivative on this, I could show that it fits in here. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to do a derivative on this and see if this and its derivative fit in my differential equation. Let me copy down the original. The original was y equals cx squared. Let me do a derivative on that. You ready? I would get y prime equals, power rule it, c is a constant, 2cx. Okay, check this out. I have an original. I have its derivative. To prove that this is a solution to this, I have an original. I have its own derivative. Here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to take this y and put it there. And I'm going to take this y prime and I'm going to put it there. And I'm going to like prove or show that this is a solution to this, by simply finding its derivative and putting both of these into my differential equation. I'm subbing these into my differential equation. So here I go. Y prime, sub this in. Sub this in there, and then right here it's asking for y. So I'm going to sub this in for my y. Are these really equal? Sure they are. So what I've just done is I have shown that this. I have shown that this original equation, I also called it a family of functions. I have shown that this is a solution to this differential equation. I have shown that this family of functions is a solution to this differential equation. How did I do that? I took my original, I found its derivative, and I subbed both of them into my differential equation. What's a differential equation? It has a y and a y prime. How do you show that something is a solution to a differential equation? Plug in the y, plug in the y prime. Make sure they match. Okay, so that's just some vocabulary. I can't say straight up that you're going to do that every single time in every single problem. I just want you to understand the vocabulary that's involved when something is a solution to a differential equation. What is a family of functions? Things like that. So I'm going to keep going. I'm going to work through this example. This is saying find the particular solution to this equation. And I could call it a differential equation, but it doesn't have a y in it, so that's going to seem weird to you. Whatever. dy dx equals e to the x minus 6x squared. Okay? Here's what it's saying to do. Find a solution. That means find a y equals. Find what the original was. So how are you going to do that? How are you going to go from, hey, this is a derivative. I need to find what was the original y. So check this out. Is this easy to do an antiderivative on? I think you're going to find that it is. This piece is easy to do an antiderivative. This piece is easy to do an antiderivative. Do it. So antiderivative of e to the x is e to the x. Antiderivative of 6x squared is raise it and divide plus c. Now, see this function? It's an equation. It has a c in it. What is c? At this point, c could be anything. You know what I'm going to call this equation that has a C in it? It's a family of functions. A family of functions. Now, just for fun, I graphed several members of this family of functions. So I used my graphing calculator. And I said, what did I do? Here's what I did. I typed in the function and said, oh, this first one, I said, what if c is 0? So I left the c blank. That's my y1. The next one, e to the x, what if c were positive 2? So I typed that one in. What if c were negative 3? So I typed that one in, okay? I typed in three possible members of this family of functions. And I graphed them. And here's what the graph looks like. All three of them are graphed. So I want you to just visualize how each of these three graphs has basically the same shape because they're all basically the same function. You're going to be tempted to call this an y-intercept, and it's not because it's an exponential, and you smart ones can figure that one out. But anyway, the value of this kind of changes the height of the graph. But doesn't matter what it is, they each still have pretty much the same shape, okay? So what we're looking here is sort of, if this is a family of functions, we're sort of looking at a family portrait with three members of the family present, okay? This is a picture of this particular family of functions with only three members present. Now, go back to the original problem. It says, it doesn't say find the general solution. It doesn't say find the family of functions, which I've done. It says find the particular solution. Find the very specific equation. Find the member of the family that contains the point 1, 0. So, no problem. This represents all members of the family. Let's see what member of the family has this ordered pair in it. So I subbed in 0 for y, subbed in 1 for x, and it looks like I'm going to get 2 minus e. C is equal to 2 minus e. So put this up there for C, and I have y equals e to the x minus 2x cubed plus 2 minus e. This is called one particular solution. And by the way, I could also just say this is the general solution, right? The one that contained the C, I can call it a family of functions, or I could also call it the general solution. This one is just one very specific solution. I could also call it one member of the family. General solution has a C in it. Particular solution is you have found what C is, you have used a point on the original function to figure out what C is. It's a particular solution, it's one member of the family. Okay, hope that makes sense. A solution, remember, a solution to a differential equation is the original function. Now, the next one, this is a good, I like this problem. It's pretty algebra intense. Like, it's gonna pretty much take up our whole page. And the thing that worries me is I don't want you to get so caught up in the algebra that you forget big picture what we're doing. So I'm gonna try to remember to remind you every now and then what it is we're doing. So here it is. Show that every member of this family of functions, this is a family of functions that has a C in it, it's a y equals. Show that for all possibilities of C, this is a solution to this differential equation. This is a differential equation. This is a family. Or a general solution. Okay. And we're gonna show, and I don't think it's that easy to do, we're gonna show that this is the solution to this. So we're gonna show that if I did a derivative on this, this is what I would get. So I'm going to start by doing a derivative on the family of functions. So we're saying that's the original function. I'm getting ready to do a derivative on it. I'm going to use quotient rule. Now, I'm going to go faster than I would go in class, because if you're watching this on a video, you have the ability to pause it and copy and then back it up if there's something that you don't understand. So I'm going to go low, D high, okay, constant e to the t, low, d high, minus high, d low. Holy moly. I think I'm going to say that this negative, multiply times this negative, turns them both into a positive. I can also say that this term and this term both have c e to the t. I'm going to factor that out. C e to the t. Here's what's left. I have my first binomial plus my second binomial. Those cancel each other out. I'm left with 2. So 2 c e to the t all over. Now, so I've taken the derivative. Now let me go back up and let me write, remember what the differential equation was? It's y prime equals 1/2 times the quantity y squared minus 1. Okay. I was given originally the function called y. It's that family of functions up there. It's the fraction. I just found y prime. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this blue differential equation to prove that these are linked, right? To prove that this is the solution to this, to prove that they're linked. I'm going to sub in the original and the derivative. That's what's cool about a differential equation. You can sub in the original, you can sub in the derivative. That's what I'm going to do. So, I'm going to need some space. So the derivative looks like this. Oh, dang. 2c e to the t over quantity original squared minus 1.
Okay, I hope that you can see very clearly what it is I did. The derivative that I found down there, I subbed it in for y prime. The original that was given to me up there, I subbed it in for y. And now, the next 25 minutes of the video is going to be me proving that these two sides are equal. Just kidding. It's not going to take 25 minutes, but it is going to take a while. And what did it say? Did it say show? Yeah. So it's kind of like you're doing a proof. You've got to be careful what you do. You can't add something to both sides of the equation. We're trying to prove that this is an equal sign here. We're trying to prove that this side is equal to this side. You can't treat it like an equation by adding something to both sides. You can't cross multiply. You can't multiply both sides by something. You can't treat it like an equation. You have to just like work with one side of it. So I'm going to start working with just this side.
This, I'm just going to write same, equals, here I go, 1/2.
Let's work with this. I think that this needs to be squared. So we're going to need to take the quantity 1 plus c e to the t and multiply by itself. I think most of you can foil that in your head. But if you can't, write them down separately. Do your first, your outer, your inner, and your last.
Okay, so when I do that, I get 1 times 1 is 1 plus 2 of those terms plus...
When I multiply this times itself, I get this constant squared times e to the t times e to the t is e to the 2t.
So c squared e to the 2t over, and when I square the bottom, it's the same except the middle term is negative, 1 minus minus 1.
Two options. You can throw in your 1/2, or you can work on turning this into having a common denominator as this.
I think that's what I'm going to do. Sounds like a blast. 1/2.
So, to get a common denominator, I basically took this and multiplied by this denominator, top and bottom. Be careful, you're going to have to like distribute your negative sign.
And I think you all can do this part in your head. Let's see.
Picture distributing your negative sign, right? You've got a positive 1 minus a 1. Those are going to go away.
I'll cancel those out.
Okay. You've got a positive 2c e to the t and another positive 2c e to the t.
That makes 4.
I got those. And then I've got a positive c squared, blah, 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 and distribute a negative c squared, blah, blah, blah. Those cancel each other out. So this whole huge mess simplifies numerator to this and denominator to 1 minus 2c to the t plus c squared.
And then my 4 and my 2 cancel out, or reduce. And remember what I had in green way up there? 2c e to the t over that binomial squared? That is 1. I multiply that out. And I kind of did what I've been telling you all to not do over and over and over again. Where was it? Way back up here. When I squared this fraction, I multiplied out the numerator and I multiplied out the denominator. And I keep telling you all, don't multiply out the denominator unless you have a really good reason. And I did. I was just on a roll and I multiplied it out. Which is why. When I brought this green fraction down, I went ahead and multiplied out the denominator just so you could see that they actually were the same. Okay, whew. So what did we just do? That was a lot of work. We ended up with the same thing on both sides. We just proved that this family of functions is a solution to this differential equation. Big picture, how did we do that? We subbed in the original and its derivative. We subbed in the original and its derivative into the differential equation. I want you to kind of get used to that, subbing in an original and a derivative to the differential equation. All right. Now, if that's a lot and you want to stop the video right now, you can. I am going to go ahead really quickly. This is kind of day two. We're not going to do this one, but we are going to do these down here. So if I've overwhelmed your brain, stop the video, work on the worksheet for a while, and then watch the last, 5 minutes or so of this video. We're at the 33-minute mark, basically. Okay, so... determine which graph shows the solution to the initial value problem. So keep in mind, you know what this is. This is a derivative. You could call it a differential equation. Its antiderivative is a y equals function. We don't know exactly what it is. It would have a plus c on the end of it until I did this, right? So but here's what's asking. Which one of these could be your y? Which of these could be the y that has this as a derivative and this as a point on it? Which of these could be the y function that has this as a derivative and this as an ordered pair on my y function? So first of all, let's see if we can eliminate any. Do all three of these contain the point 0, comma, pi over 2? Yes? Yes? Yes. Okay, well that kind of does me no good. I couldn't rule any out. So what about this one? This is the derivative of one of these. This is the word association. Ready? I'm not going to say derivative right now. This shows the slope of the tangent of one of these. So there's several ways to go about this. You can say, well, at 0, this one has a slope of 0. Yes or no? When x is 0, does this equal 0? Doesn't. It's not that one. How about this? When x is 0, this function has a slope or derivative of about 1-ish. When x is 0, this function has a slope, aka a derivative,
that equals one-ish.
Ooh. Yes, I think that could be it.
Let's check this one. This when x is 0, this has a slope of negative 1-ish. 0, slope of negative, no way.
Pretty cool. Let's do the next one.
This shows the slope. This shows the derivative of one of these graphs. Which one is it? And the graph has to contain the point negative 1, comma 1. Well, they all do. Okay, so that doesn't do me much good. All right, so we can do it the same way. How about both of these? For both of these, when x is 0, the slope of my graph is 0. When x is 0, slope is 0. When x is 0, slope is 0. When x is 0, slope is 0. Oh, yes. Yes, yes. Just double check. When x is 0, slope is like negative 1-ish? No. Okay. So it's either going to be this one or this one. How about this? When x is negative 1, slope is positive. When x is negative 1, slope is positive. Oh, yeah, I think so. When x is negative 1, slope is negative. When x is negative 1, no. Uh-uh.
It's got to be that one. All right, that wraps it up. As you go through and do your worksheet, your goal is not to obtain answers. Your goal is to understand what is going on in each and every problem. And if you get hung up on the math, that's fine. Let me help you. If you don't understand what's going on, that's fine. Let me help you. But make sure you're like talking to yourself during every problem that you understand what it is you're doing. Good luck.